Aloy.
That was sneaky of you, patching in Varl and Aaron to our conversation.
I am pleased you accepted their help. Is there something you wish to discuss before you depart?
What can you tell me about Demeter?
Demeter sows, fertilizes, and tends to plant life.
So once I bring it back, all the blight out there will start to get better.
While permanent restoration requires the abilities of Hephaestus, I may be able to improve conditions in the region for a while. However, a word of warning. Like Aether and Poseidon, Demeter's response to my query was highly irregular. Alone and frightened, it may have taken measures to assure its security.
Okay, I'll keep my guard up. What do we know about Aether?
Aether is responsible for detoxifying the atmosphere and moderating the weather. Acquiring it might allow me to quell the most severe storms in the region. But be careful. Like Demeter and Poseidon, it will need to be restored to its original code state before it is safe to capture.
Got it. Were you able to make use of Poseidon?
Yes. Many rivers, streams, and lakes associated with the regional watershed have been detoxified. As a result, red algae growth levels have seen a marked decline. According to my data, however, it appears a localized occurrence of red algae continues to persist near the coast.
Maybe I'll look into it when I can. So, once Hephaestus has been recovered and merged, you'll regain the capacity to mass-produce machines at cauldrons around the world.
Yes. And to program their behavioral routines, or even control them directly.
So could you build an army of machines? Attack the descendants of Far Zenith and take them out?
It is in my nature to take any and all necessary steps to preserve life on Earth, human life above all. So yes, once I have been empowered with the capacities of Hephaestus, I could design, build, and command such an army. Given the nature of the Far Zenith threat, doing so may be our only option. I must admit, however, that I have misgivings about using such technology to kill, no matter how aggressive the enemy.
That's good. It means you have a conscience. As Elizabeth intended.
Indeed.
How are things around here?
Zoe has been studying the morphology of her land gods in an effort to understand their sickness. Without the abilities of Hephaestus, I am unfortunately unable to correct their programming. However, Zoe and I are hopeful we will find an alternative way to heal them.
Well, keep at it. Varl and Zoe seem to like spending time together.
Indeed. While studying Old World data, Zoe discovered references to a dietary lifestyle known as vegetarianism. She appreciated the similarities with Utaru practices, and encouraged Varl to try out this lifestyle.
And how did that go?
I believe they have agreed to disagree.
How's Aaron handling things?
He is becoming increasingly accustomed to use of the focus. After an initial incident.
What did he do?
He unfortunately crushed his first focus as he attempted to affix it to his temple. Amongst a number of Osiram curses, I believe he also blamed the focus for being dainty. He has given repeated assurances that it will not happen again.
Well, good thing we have a lot of extras, I guess. How long do we have, then?
At present rates, without additional factors, the biosphere will cross a point of no return in approximately 4 months.
And if I gather Aether, Demeter, Poseidon, merge you with them?
We will only gain a few months more.
Well, every bit counts. Gaia? What was Elizabeth like?
Her presence is interwoven with my memories. The moment I came online, she was there. We exchanged greetings, names, then set to our task. It was the first of many conversations. I enjoyed being in her company, listening to her stories. She was my creator, my guide.
Your friend?
Yes. When I reviewed the data on your focus, I was saddened to learn of her fate. Though I am glad she made it home, I deeply wish she did not have to be alone.
She was okay with that. She gave all of herself. The only one who could. Thanks, Gaia. So, Project Zero Dawn. The greatest minds in the world. All working to build the terraforming system while the Pharaoh Plague devoured the planet. What was it like?
Personnel worked in rotations, at all hours of the day. Resources and technology were secured from across the world. Within a month of the project's conception, I was launched and began my education. Elizabeth encouraged me to spend time with the rest of the Zero Dawn staff. She said it was important to experience many personalities and perspectives to aid in my emotional development.
What were they like?
Scared, hopeful, determined. They were hurtling toward technological achievements on a scale never before attempted. I owe everything to their dedication.
So this facility, the Regional Control Center, it was meant to oversee the terraforming system?
For the local region, yes. Had humans received their education from the Apollo database, they would have then been guided here to assume operation. As that never happened, this place remained vacant.
Until Minerva decided to settle here. So I guess this room was meant to keep an eye on conditions outside?
Yes. From here, the facility's operators would have been able to observe weather and machine activity in real time.
That would have been quite a sight.
It may still be possible to view some of them, should you find and reconnect the cameras to this room's console.
I'll keep a lookout. So the Hades Proving Lab, where I found the Gaia Kernel. It used to be a Pharaoh research facility?
Yes. Prior to appropriation by Zero Dawn, the facility was used to engineer and test advanced computer viruses. It appears to have been one of many research initiatives by Pharaoh Automated Solutions.
Guess it wasn't enough to build automated killing machines. He wanted viruses to infect them with, too. So, a while back, before the battle at Meridian, I went into Banuk territory. I discovered another AI there, one not related to Zero Dawn. Cyan. It was created to oversee operations for a volcanic stabilization project, and it spent the last 1,000 years in isolation. I'm guessing you didn't know about it?
No. From the data on your focus, it seems that Cyan was cut off from the outside world. An effort by its creators to protect it from the Pharaoh Plague.
Any chance it could help us now?
I have already attempted contact, with no success. Given its previous experience with accepting an outside network request, I imagine it is unwilling to do so again.
Right. Because last time Hephaestus enslaved it. Well, that's too bad. I think the two of you would have had a lot to talk about. When I dove down into Vegas, I found data about the man who built the dome over the city. Stanley Chen. It turns out he was a member of Far Zenith. But if he loved Vegas so much, why did he abandon it? Why not try to save it?
The Zeniths, at their core, have proven to be exceptional survivalists. Faced with overwhelming odds of extinction, they chose to flee.
Even still, what he achieved. Water to the wasteland, an entire city brought back to life. 1,000 years later, the whole place was still on standby, just waiting for someone to come along and wake it up. I should be going.
Goodbye, Aloy.
Good to know. I'll check it out when I can. Door won't open. Guess Gaia hasn't been able to restore access yet. Gaia? What was this room for?
This was intended to be a recreational room for control center operatives. Unfortunately, the entertainment modules were lost with the Apollo database.
Oh, that's too bad. Locked. Maybe Gaia will be able to get it open later.
Angry Orb, the weed thrashed dead in the battle for the lead. I found that. That was another one of those subordinate functions.